Playing audio from my hard disk over a network was introduced to the market a quarter of a century ago. Still, many see it as a complex new technology, and we don't make it easier by using different names for the same devices. In this video, I will try to clarify things a bit. For now, let's speak of file-based music players, players that I use to play FLAC, MP3 or other music files. Let's analyze what functions are needed in such player. Storage, where the music files are kept. An index or database to easily find music files based on artist, track name, album name and so on. To do this, each audio file needs to have metadata that contains this information, often called ID tags. See my metadata and organizing playlist. Next, you need a control function that allows you to select music, put it in a playlist, and send the files from storage to the transport/interface. From there, it gets sent to a digital to analog converter, where the bits are converted into music that can be played on an amplifier that is driving a pair of speakers or headphones. Initially, computers were used as file-based music players. Storage, indexing, control and interface were all present in the computer. The digital-to-analog conversion was also present, but given the sound quality of the internal DAC, an external DAC was preferred, often connected over USB, sometimes over SPDIF. The DAC was connected to the amplifier. As people started using more and more uncompressed or lossless compressed file formats, the system drive became too small, so larger ones were added. Not all computers could accommodate additional drives, so external drives were added, mostly connected over USB. Nowadays, most homes in developed countries have a home network. So now NASes can be used as external storage. A NAS contains a hard drive or cluster of hard drives connected over the network. Functionally, very similar to a USB drive, but technically rather different. The home network also made it possible to use a network bridge. A network bridge is a small device holding a tiny computer optimized for audio that provides a digital audio output over the network. With the right software, you can use the computer in the study to play music via the network bridge to the DAC in the living room. The control software and database still run on the computer in the study, while a smartphone or tablet functions as a remote control. Network bridges often support multiple protocols and can therefore be used with a wide variety of software, such as Spotify, Tidal Direct, Rune, Squeezebox, Lyrian Music Server, DLNA, and others. There are network bridges that have a SPDIF output, an AES/EBU output, an I2S output, a Toslink output, or a USB output. Often only one of these is present, although some might offer two or three different connections. See my reviews, you can find them in my two playlists mentioned in the description. Most computers are not made for audio reproduction and will pollute the connection to the DAC in several ways. That is due to the noisy power supplies, low-quality clock crystals and other clock crystals that interfere with the crystal used for audio. Digital music players contain the same function blocks relevant for audio playback, but here the accent is towards preserving audio quality. Before you think digital audio is just ones and zeros, it's 2025 now. We now understand that polluting of the analog square wave used to transport those ones and zeros can have profound effect on the sound quality. A good sounding music player will have a quality components, good build quality and a clever design. I give you a few examples of where it can go wrong. To start with the power supply. A noisy power supply will raise the noise floor on the power rail. That can influence the threshold and thus shift the transition from 1 to 0 and vice versa in time. If the power supply is not dimensioned properly, the voltage on the power rail can fluctuate, again shifting the transition from 1 to 0 and vice versa in time. Flip-flops are used throughout the digital equipment. These are electronic equivalents of switches that are used to pass on ones and zeros. These also come in qualities. Cheap ones are slow, thus again influencing timing. And then there is the clock crystal. These also come in qualities and cost accordingly. The cheapest can be had for $0.25, while high-end ones can cost up to $100 or more. That's a factor of 400. They differ in things like phase noise and temperature stability, again influencing timing. All these aberrations do no harm as long as the audio signal is in the digital domain. But during the digital to analog conversion, they can, and almost always will, influence the sound quality. That is why audiophile switches improve the sound quality, although there are those that don't believe that. Often ICT personnel is trained to think in network technology only. And Ethernet, when implemented well, is bit perfect. But when it arrives at the DAC, the small aberrations in the square waves that transport the ones and the zeros produce jitter in the clock input of the DAC chip. Jitter causes distortion in the analog outputs that can be quite audible but is not measurable using analog and FFT measurements. High-end audio technology is no part of the ICT curriculum. See my video Ethernet and Audio. Link in the usual places. Today, all digital music players connect to your home network and thus can be called network players. Can they also be called streamers? I don't think there's an official naming convention, but in general, streaming means transport over the network. So when you play music from your NAS or from Tidal, Qobuz, Spotify or other streaming services, you are streaming, regardless whether you do that using your smartphone, computer, digital music player or AV receiver, and regardless whether you play audio or video. That makes the term streamer rather generic. The term that is more specific is digital transport. Like a CD transport, a digital transport does not have an internal digital to analog converter. Along the same lines, a digital player, like a CD player, would have a DAC integrated. When also the power amplifier is integrated, often the name streaming amplifier is used. As we have seen, there needs to be an index/database and there needs to be control software. In most cases, that is part of the music server software, like DLA server, Lyrian music server, previously named Logitech Media Server, Rune, JRiver or Nirvana, and so on. But there are network music players that do the indexing and control locally. Two brands spring to mind, Sonos and Bluesound. The advantage is that searching music and playing it can go faster. The disadvantage is that this is done in the player's memory, which can limit the number of tracks that can be indexed. For a normal-sized catalog, that's no problem though. With the current state of technology, differences in speed between local or server-based searching are very small. If you have any question left on this subject, post it below this video and, given time, I will try to answer. But please keep the question short and sweet. And that brings us to the end of this video. There will be a new video coming soon, although during summertime, review samples are hard to get. And my wife and I want to make another road trip. This time to Portugal. So there will be less videos during the summer. But if you subscribe to this channel or follow me on Patreon, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram or TikTok, you stay up to date on new videos. Patreon and YouTube Premium subscribers see my videos a week earlier and free of YouTube commercials. Help me reach even more people by giving this video a thumbs up or linking to this video on the social media. I would greatly appreciate it. A big thank you to the viewers who support this channel financially. It keeps me independent and is a nice token of appreciation for my work. 1 euro, pound, dollar or equivalent is already very valuable in a time where declining advertising revenues and depreciating dollar are putting a pressure on my motivation. You can use the QR code on the screen or the links in the description below this video on YouTube. I'm Hans Beekhuizen, thank you for watching and see you in the next video. And whatever you do, enjoy the music.